Alright, hello everybody. Welcome back to the 3D Mario Madness Season 3. We are now in the semi-final. This is where the fun shit happens. This is where the gladiators come to battle. Today we have Aria versus Radio, third seed versus second seed respectively. Say hi, guys.
Hi.
Good morning.
Yeah, how are you guys feeling? Start with Radio. How are you feeling about this match?
I love Galaxy Games so much.
And Aria, same question.
I love sandbox games so much.
Yes, we have two very competing ideologies here in the wheel room. We do have one ban for Radio, since Aria doesn't have 3D World that is banned automatically. Radio, what is your ban?
64.
Was to be expected. That is the game that Aria has a better PB in. So 64 is gone. And then we can give the wheel a quick spin.
Run it, Forzen.
No!
Forzen. Alright, here we go. Please, SMS. Please, SMS.
Please, SMG2.
That looks like G1. Oh, maybe it's G2, actually.
It's G1.
Nah, yeah, it's G1.
100%.
Alright, Aria.
Let's play the wheel again!
Yeah, Aria has a reroll, and she will use it. Let's spin the wheel again and hope it's not G2 instead.
Please, I am forfeiting. I won't forfeit. Fuck, man.
In no way. Oh no, it's SMS.
Okay.
Stop.
Go ahead.
This is massive indeed. We will take this. These are the closest PBs between the two players with SMS any percent.
Okay.
This is a massive dog.
I have a non-zero chance of winning.
We'll take that. All right, we will set up the stream and we will be. We have the modifier wheel. I haven't commentated in a while. Sorry.
The amendment.
You know, let's just go 2D. Yeah, modifier wheel. Let's spin it. My bad. I forgot this isn't season 2. Wait. Hold the
20%.
Fuck on. Okay, yeah, it's just 20%. I thought it was gonna spin a little longer. Alright, so, it will be SMS
this
any
is
percent,
a good match.
That is your match. Yeah, this is a good match. I'm glad for this. This is probably the best outcome on the wheel.
If I lose by 2 seconds, I'm gonna cry. Three last carries. So long.
Yeah. Now we will go and set up the stream, and we will be back with SMS any percent. Don't go anywhere. See you guys in a bit. Alright, welcome back everyone. We are, I believe, ready to get going. The runners are. Aria, you need to set your timer to offset for each round.
Gretch Sunshine goes insane.
You probably asked this earlier, but yeah, my game is on 16x9. I forgot about it.
Stretched fucking 4-3, let's go.
Can I still is it too late?
I mean, we'll just rock it. We'll just rock this. I mean, this doesn't look bad to me because I play 4-3 stretched.
Oh, yeah.
Why is the okay. FI semifinals lowercase? What is happening? That's so goofy.
CSGO reference. 4-3 stretch CS reference, real shit. Silo when he can't see someone in his peripheral vision.
Alright, I'm ready.
Alright. Yeah, we will be using Peach File here because we don't want to watch the fucking cutscenes. But Aria is on the 3DS, so we can't use Hackfile. Did you... Why did you start?
Oh my god.
Okay, ready?
Absolutely head-ass behavior. Alright, are you both ready?
Yep.
Yeah.
Alright. 3, 2, 1... Go. Good luck.
Good luck.
Good luck.
All right, and now we have the. Okay, that actually didn't take long.
What is happening?
Pretty well synced, Pac-Man. Aria sliding around a little bit. All right, so we're starting off on Airstrip. You know the drill. We have to fight this dumbass piranha, which is actually, fun fact, the only piranha in the game that you can constantly spray. You'll notice, I don't know if either of them will do it, or if they're both just going to use spam sprays, but the actual optimal strategy is, yeah, what Radio's doing here, you can spray the polluted piranha plant the whole time. It only applies to this one on Airstrip. Maybe they wanted to make the game a little bit easier when you started off, while you're getting used to the controls and stuff. But, yeah, that is in fact the case, and that is the strategy for the first one. So, yeah, that's Shine 1 out of the way, and now we get to watch the giant court cutscene, because Peach File only makes Airstrip faster, it does not make Bianca 2 faster. Also, you'll notice Aria is on 3DS and Radio is on Wii. Radio does not have a memory card in, so he can just spam A whenever a save text box comes up, whereas Aria, on the other hand, has to press down twice and then A to continue without saving, kind of like how SM64 does it. But Aria does have the advantage by version overall, because even though Radio is playing on the Japanese version of SMS, which is the fastest version for any percent, Aria is playing on 3DS, which just completely trumps any Wii version in loads anyway. So, yeah. But despite that, Radio does have a 19-second faster PB, but, I mean, for a race that is an hour and a half long, 19 seconds is basically insignificant, which is why I'm really looking forward to this. So we got a bit of fuck 3DS from Radio. Wait, you use ProCon Aria? Okay, that's insane. That is wild. Although I think you actually do you have to use ProCon for like 3DS SMS? Can you still do like analog presses? Is GC for GBS? Oh, interesting. Okay, that's wild. And that's it. So yeah, we have the court cutscene. I unfortunately can't hear it, but you'll hear the Among Us reference at some point during this. Yeah, I can't read Italian or Japanese, so, yeah. Can you talk about what your thoughts on salt and vinegar chips are? They're pretty fucking good. I have some salt and vinegar Pringles downstairs. I was thinking of going and getting them, but then I would have to drink a shit ton of water during this commentary stint, and if it rolled G2, I would have probably died by the end of it. I would have had the driest mouth on planet Earth. So, yeah, I chose not to. I might go absolutely destroy that tube of Pringles after, what is it? After this commentary, though. We'll see.
problem.
Playing Raid Shadow Mario, Legends, Pagman, Neil farming money for years. Hey, Winter, you love to see it. Oh, so yeah, that was a lot of information about versions. I pretty much, oh, little bit of lag. Aussie internet. Yeah, I kind of got all my explaining out during airstrip, and now I have nothing to talk about during the cutscene, but thankfully it'll end sometime soon. Is there a JP restream for this? That is sick. Yeah, I will pin that. That's cool as fuck. Pin my balls. Hey, fucking yo. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they are, yeah, doing their own restream. To ensure the return of the shine sick. Sprites is to keep the island from it's really cool that the JP community is like it's still connected, but they have like their own like subset. Like it's really cool that they're still interested in like our events and basically like create a like digestible version for a Japanese audience. Like I think in the future, as speedrunning gets bigger, it'd be really cool to have like, you know, restreams in every language. I mean, we've tried German restreams for multi Mario tournaments in the past to interesting levels of success. which I was involved in the grand finals of the Mario Kart tournament. The German restream went hard, even though we were incredibly biased because one of the players was a German. So yeah, we do have a little bit of a stream lag here, but Radio's gameplay is still up and running, so we can talk about him for a bit. So yeah, I did say there was a 19 PB difference. To clarify, Radio's PB is better, but it shouldn't matter too much in the grand scheme of things. Yeah, Australian internet really taking a hit. Yeah. I know that German guy. Wow. We're having a little bit of internet issues here. I could try and I could pull up the runner streams on my own screen and fill you guys in on what is going on at the very least. Actually, I don't think I know Arya's alt, so yeah, I'll be able to do that in a limited capacity. Mario? Link to Discord profile. Okay, I will find it. Ah, I see. Yeah, there we go. Alright, so yeah, Radio currently working on killing Shadow Mario in a brutal drive-by. We will find out if he got the fast kill at some point. It does look like he did based on the fact that he's already returned. Also, yeah, Arya already in Bianco 2, actually. I didn't see what happened to Radio to cause this discrepancy, but yeah, Arya currently with the lead. Some nice windmill wall kicks from Radio. Does look like we have both streams up and running again now, which is nice, and decently synced at that. Is audio fine? I have no idea. I think, yeah. Better question for chat. Yes, okay. Audio is fine. Alright. Now in the PD Piranha fight, the strat for this guy is basically to just stand, I say behind, but it's basically past the left and right sides. Like, if you just imagine two long lines coming out of the left and right side of PD, as long as you're stood behind them, those lines, he will instantly turn around and open his mouth. So that's just the strat for this. Radioing a slightly faster kill. I think he might have messed it up there. Yeah, PD swinging his head. You basically backflip spam spray. Having a bit of an issue with it though. Arya going with the more consistent. Save her a little bit of time over Radio here. Also, I am actually going to open up the, what is it? Streams on my own monitor, and I'll give you guys an idea of what's going on. Love how we as a community can bond over the global issue of shit, Ian. Hey, listen, it happens to the best of us. I'm not even sure if I would have been able to restream this, because I'm at my mum's house, which is also why my voice probably sounds different. It's because I'm using Eden's microphone, which is actually a better microphone. So, yeah, enjoy the crisp quality while it lasts. I probably should buy a new microphone, to be fair. But I've had my Blue Snowball for like 6 years, I think over 6 years now. It's just too close to my heart. All right, yeah. So Aria entering the Cave in Bianco 3 around the same time as Rydia's heading over to it. Also, yeah. While I'm commentating using the actual streams, I will be slightly ahead, but I'll do my best to give an idea of what's going on. But yeah, you can kind of see it on the mainstream. Is that the same mic that sounded like shit in CS:GO in CS:O? Yes, it is. I managed to fix it, mostly by bringing it closer to my face and also installing the drivers for it. Made it sound a lot better. So yeah. Because this mic is actually more expensive than mine. My mic is like £60 and this one was 100. So yeah, like on paper this is a better microphone, I just didn't have the drivers. Thinking about it, I'm not actually sure if I have the drivers for my actual mic or if I've just been doing it raw the whole time. So yeah, there we go. Now we have the streams back. So yeah, both runners fighting the polluted piranha plant. Are a little bit ahead, and like I said before, in airstrip you cannot just shoot this guy at all times. You do have to wait until he opens his mouth. We're also going to be going for travel skip here, which is where you basically enter Bianco at the same time that the cutscene is playing. I think Aria got it here. Nice. So yeah, you can see both cutscenes play at the same time. Do not gender the piranha. Okay, my bad. Both cutscenes play at the same time, which saves the travel from Rico back to Bianco. So, yeah. And yeah, Rydia also getting travel skip, nice. I think it saves about 10 seconds? I could be wrong. It feels like it saves more to me, but that's also because I'm shit at the game. It probably, what is it? Probably saves less than I think it does. My movement's just not as good as most SMS runners. Yeah, there are some audio softwares that will work on every microphone, but results are probably very scattered. Me when the microwave interferes with the Wi-Fi signal. Is it like close to your router, Rosina? Because in that case, it honestly wouldn't surprise me. Technology—we're still in an age where technology is disgustingly temperamental at times. My B4 needs so much work. Bianco 4 is an incredibly underestimated stage, I feel like, in terms of movement. Like, the difference between a good Bianco 4 and a bad Bianco 4 probably takes like tens of hours of practice. Like, it's not just a like learning a different line or learning a different piece of movement. Like, there's, you know, a decent few momentum spins involved and stuff like that, which can be really hard to control. And also hard to execute at times, if you're me in Rico 1. But, you know, we're not here to talk about my shoddy SMS gameplay. Probably having a bit of issue getting up this hill. Let's get there eventually, though. We'll be studying the Peter Piranha fight. Petey is a dick in the sense that its patterns are completely RNG. I think there are about 700 different patterns that Petey can take. A little bit of shit-talking going on in the chat. Gonna get a disqualification for BM here. But yeah, I think there are about 700 different patterns that, that Petey can take. And some of them will literally lose you like a flat minute, as far as I'm aware. So yeah, I mean, Arya's starting off with a good pattern here. Petey just dropping down immediately. You're gonna be able to get a quick hit off. Radio also seemingly getting a good pattern. As long as PD doesn't go over the wall. Alright, nice. You're gonna chug GPS just like that. Isn't it like 3,000 plus? Maybe it is. I remember 700 being a number once, but I could be wrong about that. Yeah, Aria, I think also getting decent RNG here if PD stops immediately. Yeah, this isn't too bad. Obviously, ideally, PD just goes straight to that position, but going over the wall is not bad at all. So yeah, Aria attempting to do the spam spray strat, messes it up, gives Radio a little bit of time back, potentially, unless Radio makes the same mistake. It doesn't look like he's going for the backflip strat. Also, interesting piece of information for any future SMS runners in chat. Please don't run this game. But if you do, I'm kidding, SMS is pretty good. If you do, PD, similar to the Bianco 2 fight, you usually want to stand at the side of PD once it lands, because PD has a chance to shoot one tornado. And if you stand in the right position, you will dodge that tornado and cause PD to immediately turn and open its mouth right after that. So yeah. Also, both runners actually getting pretty good RNG here, which is nice. I'm glad that we're not, like, getting an immediate disconnect off of the back of sheer luck. So yeah, Aria grabbing the shine as Radio's just killed PD. Yeah, almost a 16 Bianco 4, which is pretty good. At least for us in the multi-Mario community. Yeah, 17.03 is still solid. And Radio getting a... I think about a 17.16? Yeah, about a 17.16. So about 13 seconds between the runners right now. But we are going into GBS, which, even if you don't know anything about Sunshine, you'll probably know about GBS. One of probably the more annoying tricks, especially as a new runner, and also kind of an annoying trick at a top level due to the absolutely asinine setups that people use to save time. But yeah, we'll see how the runners handle it. We first obviously have to unlock Gelato, which is, you know, done by killing a polluted piranha plant, like pretty much every other level in this game. I say every other level, it's only really Bianco, Rico, and Gelato. The rest are just unlocked. Commentator spreading misinformation on the internet. Absolute sacrilege. So yeah. So we might see Radio going for a strat here. Yeah, there we go. So you can see Radio is gaining momentum before entering the cutscene, which will basically push him forward when the cutscene starts. I think Aria did it as well, and I think might have actually executed it better. But basically, the momentum that you have going into the cutscene actually pushes you forward a bit. But there is a risk to that. If you're going too fast, you'll actually smash into the lighthouse. And slide backwards because of the sludge on the ground. So, yeah, it can be a bit of a blessing and a curse. But, yeah, here we see Aria going for GBS. Let's see if it goes well for her. Picking up the coconut, doing a... I don't know if that's a buffered spin jump onto the top of the cabana. This looks like a first try. Nice! First try GBS from Aria. She'll be happy about that, for sure. See how Radio fares. 57 ahead of PB. Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me. This has been a really good run for Aria so far. Good sh-movement with the plumber. And yeah, Radio also seems like a first try. I think that was Radio's first try. If it was, then good shit. Yeah, good GBSs for both players either way. Yeah, Aria finishing up Gelato here. Another tidbit of SMS information. Basically, the goal of any percent is to beat the 7th stage in every single level. Which is Shadow Mario, which completes the level as far as the game is concerned. Which is why GBS is so powerful. Spoiler. Spoiling a game that is older than me. If you haven't played this game yet, it's your loss. So yeah, the reason that GBS is so powerful is because GBS allows you to collect the 8th shine in Gelato Beach, which instantly unlocks all the shines after it, so you can instantly do Gelato 7. There are also a couple other levels that you can skip in this run. Oh wait, you said Aria spoiling the run. My bad. So we also there is one shine in this game that you can skip and it is intentional, and that's Bianco 1. You probably noticed at the start of the race we instantly started out with Bianco 2. That is because the game does actually allow you to skip it. But all the other skips in this game are not intended, for example, EYG. I think these runners are going to be going for EYG. I'm not sure. Aria could probably clue me in once she's done with Pianta 1. But yeah, EYG basically skips Pinner 5 by going into either Pinner 3 or Pinner 4 and clipping into the park and using a Sorenstu platform to take you to the Yoshigo round, which will instantly put you into the Pinner 6 secret. Yeah, both runners will be doing it, so we'll see that. Thank you, Abel and Aria. EYG is not real. Therapist, EYG is not real. It can't hurt you. EYG. So it's actually fucked. Yeah, I wasn't paying attention to the RNG there, but it didn't seem too bad. Perfect RNG. Insane. Yeah, you'll notice RNG is a word that gets thrown around a lot in SMS. We are getting a little bit beast moded by this Chomplet, but yeah, should be able to course correct a little bit. There we go. And that's got the one done. Also, you'll notice the players pausing and unpausing after putting all of the Chomplets in the lake. It starts the cutscene immediately. So if you're close enough to the mushroom, you basically just want to jump onto it and then pause on pause, which will spawn the shine immediately. If you're far away, it's obviously not worth to do that because the shine will spawn anyway, and pausing just delays that. So you do have to have a little bit of awareness of when to pause, but I mean, it's a very insignificant amount of time anyway. Even like in the most unoptimal case, you probably lose like 1 second to pausing and unpausing. Unless your name is Silo93, and in an attempt to start the Pianta 1 cutscene, you actually exited area and killed your entire speedrun. That did happen. I don't think it's happened to anybody else since, or before then. But yeah, that did happen to Elias once. Also, Radio reading the sign really just wants to see that text. Yeah, that is a really funny clip of Elias. Bro goes to, like, start the cutscene and just exits area. I want to see if I can find that and post it in chat, actually. It's a clip worth seeing if you haven't seen it before. Keep saying percent the German way because of that. 100% Glücksspiel, bro. Yeah, SMS is not a skill check, actually. It's just a massive dice roll. Also, yeah, I don't think I finished my point on that. There is a lot of RNG in SMS. Even down to just, like, the small things. Like, the Sorenstu is an EYG. I'm pretty sure there is some RNG involved there. So yeah, this game can be pretty bullshit at times on the back of that. But usually if you have a good run and you're not at like a world record level, that won't kill it. Oh yeah, I found it. I found the clip of Elias. There you go. If you want to see the incident that I was talking about with exiting area in Pianta 1, there it is. Such a great reaction as well. he like falls fully out of his chair. There's also a 120 run as well, so it takes you slightly longer to get to Pianta 1, which probably makes it even worse to mess that up. Also, yeah, speaking of RNG, Aria is in Pianta 4, which, guess what? There is a 1 in 3 chance of where the chomp is facing when you start the level, and, you know, there are such things as optimal patterns. One is better than... well, you know, they're all better than one another. I think Aria might have gotten the worst pattern here. Is having a little bit of trouble spraying the chomp off. And unfortunately, she took damage to the chomp, which stopped her from being able to do the really fast strat, which we will hopefully see out of Radio here. Also, I think Radio, this might be the best RNG. I could be wrong. I think this is the best RNG though, if I'm not mistaken. Actually, going left at the start might be the best RNG. Also, yeah, Radio has to quickly get to this other path because the chump will basically run away from you, which is why Radio stands there. And hopefully we'll see the strat. There you go. So that's, I don't know if we call it fast bath or something like that. But basically, if you can send the chain chomp towards the pool and then spray it off and grab the chain at the right time, it will just jump straight in. So yeah, I think that's about as good as a Pianta4 can go. If I'm right about that being the best RNG path, but it might be the one where the chomp goes all the way to the left. I could be wrong. So yeah, what's up, George? I hope you're doing good. So yeah, we now have Yoshi Skip, Aria using the platform to line herself up. Gets out of bounds, gets the ledge grab, drops, hovers. This looks good. Nice, first try. We'll take that. Yoshi Skip is not I don't want to say it's not a hard trick, because it's still a little scary sometimes, but once you've got the timing down for it, once you've got the feel, you usually aren't that stressed about doing it in a run. But yeah, there are some really weird moving parts to it. For example, the reason that Aria lined herself up, whereas you'll probably want to see Radio do it, is because there's a chance that when you get the ledge grab, Mario instantly comes back up to the top of the mushroom, which can be a little bit annoying. Also, Aria's getting kind of bullied here by the straw and stews. That angle's a little scary, but I think she's fine. Okay, yeah. Even just a slight deviation to the left or right can be detrimental in this secret. Also, speaking of RNG, yeah, Aria is currently dealing with one of the worst aspects of RNG in SMS any percent. Lost enough time that she had the ability to type dickhead in the chat while first person staring at the dude. So yeah, this Pianta at the end of the level can basically, there are 6 points on this platform that the Pianta can stop at, which is completely RNG, and the time that he stops for is also completely RNG. There is such a tech known as a rat bounce, which can basically refresh the Pianta's internal timer, which you can use to manipulate him a bit. But even then, if you get better RNG, you are losing time, and there's nothing you can really do about it. Actually allowed Radio to catch up a little bit on behalf of that RNG. I don't know what the exact difference is right now. Aria selected the shine at 2807, so we'll see on Radio, does it? Is it still 13 seconds? So we're basically at the same like distance between the runners since we left Bianco, which is pretty impressive because there's been a lot of RNG levels. Okay, it's 15. But yeah, still really close. Which is exactly what I wanted, because I did not want to solo come a 3-hour G2 wash. SMS is far more interesting to commentate, both from a length POV and the fact that the runners' PVs are within 20 seconds of each other. So yeah, now we're into Pianta 6, a heavily IL'd level in the SMS community, mostly due to the in-game timer. If you haven't seen Trey's video on this level, I would highly recommend it if you're interested in Sunshine. Because yeah, this level is known for using a lot of very, not necessarily niche, but very, very like in-depth movement mechanics. So yeah, Aria refilling her water here. A little bit worried about her usage, because it is very easy to run out of water in Pianta 6. So yeah, getting the spin jump over the wall. I think Radio will be going for it as well. Yeah, nice. I think they both had to hover a little bit to get it, but yeah. Still should be saving time because going around the wall is kind of slow. Aria unfortunately not getting this early unlock on the Pianta, which Radio did, so they're actually very close to each other now. I think Radio had a slightly better Pianta 6 on the back of not having to refill water and also getting that early unlock. Also a nice bridge water slide I think actually puts Radio in the- Oh my god, the sink! Aria actually saving time on Radio due to playing on the European version, because Italian does have the fastest text, contrary to most Mario speed games where Japanese is the quickest, but zam, that was a nice sink for a second. Also yeah, really nice Pianta 6 from Radio. And yeah, we're basically within a second of each other. I suck at Pianta. Pianta is a deceptively hard level, I would say. Mostly due to the RNG, but also due to the sheer amount of jank. Yeah, that was a very nice Piazza 6 from Rydia. I didn't even mention the first-person dive that he did right at the end, which was what basically tied him up. I unfortunately do not speak Spanish, but I assume that is a Rydia enjoyer in the chat. Yeah, this is really close. Rydia unfortunately getting a little bit rolled by a... Oh, no, never mind. I thought Rydia hadn't killed Shadow Mario yet. No, okay, my bad. So yeah, Rydia now taking the lead, on the contrary to what I just said. Do what he skip? No balls. Pretty sure Rydia is not reading the chat. Said that the F Rydia just cut all at Mantic. I mean, JP is actually faster. Oh, Rydia is actually going for Honey Skip. Big man. Let's see if he gets it. I do not know what a successful Honey Skip looks like, so I'm just gonna have to, like, base this off of, like, pure guesswork. That does look good, though. I could be wrong, but it looks good. Absolutely cracked. You love to see it. Rydia with the Honey Skip. Big man, Drake's in chat. Yeah, that gives him a pretty significant lead, because Honey Skip does actually save quite a bit of time. That cutscene is long. So yeah, nice from Rydia. Ruppling out all the stops in this run. Also, yeah, both runners will be going for EYG. We got that confirmation earlier, so yeah, this is a really interesting run to watch. Yeah, now we're into Pinna 1, which has a really interesting way of doing a cutscene skip that doesn't exist in any other level of the game. Basically, if you exit area right as you're about to enter a cutscene zone, in Pinna 1 specifically, the result is a cutscene skip, because the game gets confused. It is interesting, however, that that doesn't happen anywhere else in the game. You can do it in Pianta 1 too. Psylocke catching strays and we're not even in Pianta anymore. Poor guy. So yeah, now we're on to the Mecha Bowser fight. Four shots, or four rockets to Mecha Bowser required to end this fight. So you can actually do this really quick. Also, Aria going for an interesting strat here of putting the camera into the cinematic mode. I think for her first shot, which does allow you to, like, have a lineup for it, which is pretty cool. Four shots, I'm down. Hey, at the weekend, Neil, we can do four shots. I'm down. Maybe we should play beer pong with, what is it? With, like, just straight vodka. Although that'd probably knock the cups over. Also, yeah, both runners just still insanely tied up. Like, look at this. This is a crazy-ass race. I'm so glad I got to commentate this. Back to back. I can bring Contra. W. Please don't speak before EYG. Yeah, we are very close right now, but EYG is known to be a massive pain in the ass among many a multi-Mario runner. Yeah, Aria caught up due to Italian at the end of that, what is it? The end of that Pinna 1, and probably 3DAS loads as well. Because, yeah, Aria's game does technically go faster, even though Rydia is technically... I guess not technically playing on the fast version. Playing on the fastest Wii version, but 3DAS trumps that. Nice mole skip from Aria, and Rydia. Nice. Why is Rydia's screen so wide? Aria is playing on 3D All-Stars, which is 16:9, and Rydia is playing on Wii, which is 4:3, so we either had to squish one or stretch the other. And we chose to stretch one of them. Also, holy shit. Yeah, Rydia actually caught up there, although it doesn't actually matter because of the cycles in this level. I didn't even think about that. Yeah, Rydia got to that platform slightly earlier, but just by merit of Aria entering the, I almost said sub-area, the secret, quicker. You know, the platforms just appear quicker for her. So, yeah, same deficit as we had entering the secret due to, Pinna 2 basically just being one big auto-scroller. What a race, Odyssey. When an SMO runner comes, yeah, my bad. Listen, I have some experience with this game. My 128 any percent speaks for itself. But yeah, SMS is definitely one of my weaker games as a multi Mario runner. I am very like I'm very much like an Odyssey and Galaxy one trick currently. But SMS still isn't my worst game. That would be 64. I am absolutely trash at 64. I'll say, now we have Pinner 3. Kind of an annoying stage, at least in my opinion. I'm not a huge Pinner 3 fan. It is very cool, I think, to IL, but in full game runs, it's a little bit annoying. 238, 80% duress. Oh, Arian getting a drop spin put there. Actually allows Radio to take the lead by a small margin. So interesting strat Radio's going for here. I've never seen that before, actually. Almost falls off. But yeah, that was pretty wicked. Using the top of the sail of the pirate ship in order to, what is it? In order to get up there. What is it with Odyssey mains being bad at 64? I mean, to be fair, I just haven't put that much time in 64. I imagine I could be good at it if I put the time in. But I think my, like, I probably played about 2 months of 64, like, lifetime in terms of, like, speedrun grinding, which compared to my, like, 3.5 years of Odyssey is really not that much. Like, I'll probably put in more hours within the first week of Wonder than I have into speedrunning 64. That's not actually true, but yeah, maybe within the first month that would actually be realistic, because yeah, my life is basically just a 9-day waiting game right now for Wonder to release. Alright, so we're now in Pinafore with the annoying ass snoozy Koopas, which can be, yeah, pretty temperamental when trying to wake them up. Yeah, I am literally the waiting emoji. So yeah, ideally I think you can get a one cycle in Pinafore, but I imagine both runners will be going for a two cycle here. So yeah, Aria getting 3 Snoozy Koopas with her first cycle, and Radio getting, I think also 3? Oh no, getting, oh yeah, 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 getting also 3. So yeah, as you can see, Radio did have a chance to kill that Snoozy Koopa there, but he knew he wouldn't be able to kill the second one in time, so chose just let it stand back up. And yeah, both runners finishing level at a similar time. Also, Super Mario Bros. Wonder is releasing in 9 days on the 20th. So yeah, there you go. Decent pinfall from both runners. Two cycle is the best I can do, so. It's still impressive to me. I don't know if either runner usually goes for one cycle in their attempts, but yeah, I think it is very damn hard. All right, you know what time it is, chat. It is time for EYG. This is probably, maybe the scariest trick in the run. I don't know. I feel like there are definitely some other pretty scary tricks in SMS, but yeah, EYG can be a real pain. So yeah, AD is all dungeons. A category in Zelda Tears of the Kingdom that Neil is third place in. Alright, let's have a look. I know not much about EYG. I mean, I know what it looks like when it goes well, but I can't explain the technical parts of this. So yeah, you'll have to deal with a reduced explanation. So yeah, doing fruit storage there to put the papaya sort of in Yoshi's mouth on Aria's screen. Radio will have to throw the papaya into the park due to playing on JP, which does not have fruit storage. So yeah, Aria will just be able to press B when she needs the papaya, whereas Radio will have to eat it from inside the park. They're now going to clip into this little bit of, I don't even know what you call this, like a brick skirting board, I don't fucking know, to enter the park. And then Aria will spray this stew to create a moving platform, ground pound onto it, and then eat the papaya so that she is orange and can enter the Yoshi go round when she gets there. Because if you remember from regular Pinner 6, you have to be orange. That still applies here. Radio also looking at a successful EYG attempt here. As long as he can get onto this platform. Nice. Alright, that's good. I'm glad that we got out of that without many headaches. So yeah, you saw Rydia had to turn back there and eat the papaya, whereas Arya could just do it once she was on the platform. Which I think in my mind does make EYG easier on the PAL version. But yeah. She has to be orange, that's racist. Yeah, cancel SMS. Also, nice spin jump dive from Arya. I didn't even know you could make that gap. Is Rydia going over the top? No! Oh, I spoke too soon. Rydia did try to go over the top, but didn't have the angle for it, unfortunately. Yeah, that's going to be a pretty... That's probably the biggest time loss we've seen in this run so far. So yeah, Arya taking a pretty significant lead here. Yeah, commentator's curse. Yeah, there you go. There's the successful attempt of what Rydia was trying. No! A drop spin put for Rydia! And he can't make it to the platform. That's another death. Spin jumps in SMS. You gotta love them. Also, yes, it is just me on comms pushing in. Unfortunately, nobody else was either awake or asked at this time. I almost wasn't awake, to be fair. Because literally, I started being a bit of a degenerate. I've been trying to sleep as much as possible recently. Just so Wonder comes faster. Like, I usually get up at like 7:30 in the morning. I slept in until 11 a.m. today. And I only woke up because a giant cement mixer was driving down my street. And it woke me up. It is a very unemployed problem. But, yeah. I've literally just been sleeping. That one unemployed bed. But yeah, that's been my strat recently. Literally just sleep as much as possible. I usually hate sleeping because I think it's a waste of time, but... I have nothing to do with my life for the next 9 days. So, yeah. I've just been trying to do, like, IRL cutscene skips, basically. So, yeah, now Rydia heading into Pinna 7, finishing up Pinna Park, and Arya starting Riko. You know what you can do to pass the time? Do your Raid Shadow Legends sponsorship. Bro needed to take a visit to the recycling plant. Yeah, I need to take my body to the recycling plant for 9 days. Just hibernate. Also, hi Theo. I hope you're doing good. Neil, shamelessly plugging sponsorships. This minute isn't insurmountable for Rydia. Oh, definitely not. This race is far from over. Like, in terms of, like, shine count, I think we're just over halfway. If I'm not mistaken. In terms of the run, we are, like, just over halfway. Like, there is still a decent amount of this run left. We still have Riko, the Bianco revisit, which includes 6 and 7, which 6 can be a pain. Serena, which is home to a lot of RNG and also some pretty hard stages. Noki, which is also home to some pretty hard stages. And then Corona, which, you know, Corona is a beast in and of itself. Mostly due to how shit the boat controls are. So, unfortunately, both runners missing the momentum spin jump at the start of Riko 1. Just a small observation. But yeah, like Arya said, even though the runners are a minute behind at the moment, it's not insurmountable. This is still anyone's game, for sure. We try and count they're both less than halfway. Yeah, technically. But I think some of the... I don't know if it's that the later shines are faster, more that you have to unlock less levels in the second half. Because Bianco, Riko, and Gelato are all unlocked with polluted piranha plants. PBs of both players, 123.09 for Rydia, 123.28 for Arya. So only a 19 second difference between PBs. It's more or less negligible. Assume it's because of cutscenes at the start of the run? Oh yeah, that would be a much simpler explanation. I honestly forget about the, like, cutscenes half of the time because I'm a Wii player. I, like, only play Hacked File outside of the 602. So sometimes I honestly just forget the cutscenes exist. So yeah, Arya doing the Riko 2 race where you can skip the majority of it because there are only three checkpoints that that this game uses to make sure that you've completed the track. It's okay. Stepping. Jeopardy are now heading to Rico 2. Heading into Rico 2, I guess. Meanwhile, Aria doing Rico 3. Rico 3, relatively straightforward shine, does actually include some RNG. Fun fact, the crane. I'm not sure if it's RNG whether or not the crane is traveling fast or slow, or if it's RNG where the crane starts at the beginning of the level. But basically, the crane movement isn't consistent. That's all you need to know. The crane can be in a different place. So yeah, it's pretty far away for Aria here, so you can see she's going towards the main, like, the main part of the crane. Does get the spin jump and hover into the grate. Love to see it. It is absolutely insane how much time it loses to mess that up. Because you fall into the water below, you have to return to the ship, and then you have to jump back onto the crane. It feels like an hour. I think it's RNG where it starts. Yeah, I knew it was one of them. I knew where the crane was when you get to it was RNG. Because I have IL'd that level before with the Beyblade. And I loved getting blocked by the fucking... What is it? I love getting blocked by the crane on some attempts. Are we having a little bit of a stumble here on her way to Rico 4? Unfortunately, not going for the Beyblade entry, which does look very cool, but it's stupid as hell. I do not blame her at all. I also do not do that strat. Oh my god, Aria not getting a jump out before that dive, almost died. On the other hand, Rodeo did get Rico 3 first try, so you'd love to see it. A quick spin jump dive to skip most of the platforms in that section. And then, onto the final bit, which can be pretty scary, because the path forward isn't always super obvious in this section, but Aria seeming to get through it with not many issues. Yeah, should be smooth sailing from here. Finishes up Rico 4. Nice. Alright, time for Rodeo to do Rico 4. Let's see if he does the momentum spin jump. It's run through. Yeah, I was gonna say, I assume you're not on a PB pace anymore, Aria. Rodeo also unfortunately not going for the Beyblade, but you know, you can't win them all. 45 ahead of best pace ever? Okay, yeah. I still thought it was an okay run, but I could have missed something that went like noticeably bad. Yeah, this is a very solid run from Aria. Might be beating both of the runners' PBs here, since she only needs to PB by 20 seconds to bop Rodeo. But again, we are in Rico. Technically, that entire lead could go away based on RNG if Serena 5 goes bad enough. But I'll explain the joys of King Boo once we get there, because it's a very long stage and there's a lot to unpack. Mostly involving cycle skips, which don't apply to RTA runs at all, but it's still an interesting tidbit of information that does have an hour video of it made by Trey. Which is a very good video, I again suggest you watch it. If you're interested in learning pretty much anything about, like, the, what is it? About the inner workings of Sunshine, I would very much recommend watching Average Trey's videos. I fall asleep to them most days, as of, like, the last week or two. What favors SNUS do I get? I think the grape one was alright. I didn't mind the grapesness. So, Rodeo now doing Rico 5. Not getting a spin jump there. Fuck is a SNUS? SNUS is it's basically a nicotine pouch that you put under your lip and it gives you, like, nicotine high in, like, 30 seconds. Have you tried spearmint? I'm not sure. I've tried some kind of mint. I don't know if it was spearmint. Trey's videos are dope, but during the King Boo video, Trey had to cope. Bars. Spin jumps suck, Spin rooms are cool, but spin puts suck. Which is funny because what SMS considers a spin put is like pretty lenient if you look at the actual mechanics of it. But it just seems random sometimes when like your spin put gets dropped. Like it doesn't feel like it was your fault at all. So yeah, Aria finishing up with Rico 6 here. Rico 6 can be a bit of a scary sage. You saw her slowing down a little bit at the end there. That's because on the green blooper, if you run into a wall while neutral on the control stick, you actually won't die. Aria missing the shine. This is scary. Because, hitting any wall will take you out of the shine if you have a controller stick input held. But, does manage to get the shine. Love to see it. It's Radio's turn. Richard says. So yeah, I think, as far as I'm aware on blooper stats, I think purple is the fastest one, but it has a terrible turning circle. Yellow is slow, but has a really good turning circle, and then green is about, like, the best, like, the middle of both. I could be slightly wrong about that. I think yellow might be faster than green, because that would make sense why even the smallest stick input would kill you with the yellow blooper. But yeah, it's something like that. Thought green was slowest but best turning. I think that is the case, yeah. I think you might be right on that. But yeah, it is interesting that we still choose to pick the green one. But it's just because of the maneuverability and the ability to not die when running into a wall, which does happen more often than you would think in Rico 6. I'll say a nice 0.4 Rico 7 gold from Aria, apparently. They're all the fastest when you hold up. Yeah, that is also true. If you're holding straight up, all bloopers travel at the same speed anyway. Yeah, I completely forgot about that. Oh my god, travel skip. So true. Also, yeah, Rico 7 home to probably the funniest Shadow Mario kill. You literally just line yourself up with Shadow Mario and then hold forward and start spraying when he jumps. It is potentially the easiest level to do fast in the entire game, I would say. Also, yeah, Aria now back in Bianco. Radio will be heading over there after this short cutscene. Bianco 6 honestly might be one of my favorite secrets. I do really like this level. Although I also don't do the full block skip at the start. And also the elevator is a bit boring, but I think the secret in itself is pretty cool. So yeah, you'll see Aria, I think, actually going for the wall kick. Yeah, nice. Bingo 6 is hell and I hit it as a 158 runner. Yeah, I do like the ending. I think the ending to Bianco 6 is pretty cool. Honestly, if Bianco 6 could literally just be those platforms at the end, I think it would be a better secret, real talk. Or if there just wasn't an elevator in the middle, it might actually be my favorite secret. Yeah, it's very scary, especially if you're doing the most optimal route, which both runners are, where you do Bianco 6 later. There is such thing as German and half German route, which is basically completing Bianco or just doing up to Bianco 6 on the original visit. I used to do half German, which is pretty ironic as an English native speaker that, you know, speaks German as a foreign language. That was not the reason that I did it. I just liked getting Bianco 6 out of the way. As far as I'm aware, like full German route loses 10 and I think half German only loses 3. I could be wrong about those numbers, but I think I did hear that somewhere. So, I mean, if you can justify doing harder strats in Bianco 6 because you're doing it earlier in the run, it might actually be worthwhile for you to do it earlier, which was the case for me for the longest time. But I think when I actually decided I wanted to get semi-good at— Oh, Radio! What— no! No! That's so bad. Radio has to ride the elevator again, man. Oh, that sucks. Yeah, got a like mid-air spin rather than a landing spin both times. Which was what caused Radio to die there. Because basically in SMS there are three types of spins that you can do while, like, mid-air coming towards the ground. There's a mid-air spin, there is a landing spin, and there is a buffet spin. Again, if you wish to learn more about this, Trey has a video on it. But yeah, Radio was getting mid-air spins, which is where you spin in mid-air, crazy, I know, rather than a landing spin, where you basically spin right as you're about to hit the ground, and then once, if you jump shortly after hitting the ground, you will get a spin jump, with very little interference on your actual angle as Mario, which is what we use during GBS to get a spin jump up onto the cabana, without changing our angle at all, because you obviously need a perfect angle to the, like, 65,000th degree in order to get GBS. So yeah, Aria done with Bianco, now heading into Serena, having a little bit of issue, water sliding towards the hotel manager. And now we have Serena 1, which is also a pretty decent point of RNG, and a decent point of destroying runners' hands. Due to, what is it? It was like 20 opening Serena, Shadow Mario went the wrong way. Oh, I must have missed that, my bad. So, yeah, Menta has a decent amount of RNG involved, because as you'll see, once Aria breaks away the initial glob, Menta splits off into a bunch of small Mentas, which go in completely random directions, which can make this level very annoying, for obvious reasons. The goal of Serena 1 is basically to break all of the mantas up into small mantas as quick as possible, because you will see eventually, once there are no big mantas left, all of the mantas, all of the little mantas will turn pink and start heading towards you. Like that. So yeah, you can see on Aria's screen they are all now traveling towards her, which is basically like the easier portion of the fight, because you can just find somewhere that has consistent water, like this fountain here. And just basically spray around you, and they'll all slowly come over to you, and you can just finish off the level that way. But yeah, it can be really bad if you don't manage to split off one of the big mantas, because they all have to be their smallest possible size. Even if there's one, like, you know, slightly bigger manta, you will not, they won't turn pink. And you will lose a lot of time if you can't find it for an extended period. Yeah, I would agree. I think Serena 1 is probably one of one of SMS's weakest shines from a gameplay design perspective. I feel like this was annoying for casuals, and it's annoying as hell for speedrunners. Nobody likes Serena 1. There's probably some masochist out there that likes it. Kind of like there are some like Eskimo masochists that like Hondo over all moons. But yeah, I think the average opinion is that Serena 1 sucks. Radio actually had a pretty good lineup there, but unfortunately got, like, launched away. Still looking for one more of those big ones. There we go, now Radio has pink face. I think saving a little bit of time over Aria in this level. But yeah, still has a decent deficit to recover from in Serena and Noki. Can usually tolerate Serena 1, but sometimes it just sucks. Yeah, I think the worst thing for me is just my hands. Spam spraying for this extended of a period of time actually really hurts. Probably more than you think it would. But yeah. Also, Radio actually missing out on something that Aria did at the end of the fight. If you stare towards the sun, or just in that direction, you will be facing down the steps towards the shine after the cutscene. It is a small quirk that some people don't know about, but yeah, it does save you the tiniest bit of time. I'll say, Aria getting Serena 2 out of the way here. Honestly, I would say this is one of the scariest secrets, especially at the end, and especially if you're going for the momentum spin jump strat, which I'm not sure if Aria is. We'll find out briefly. May just choose to keep it safe, especially considering she's in the lead and is aware of it. And I would not blame her at all for that. It does seem like that's what she's going for. That's completely respectable. I mean, I say I would do the same. I don't know how to do the momentum spin jump. Oh my god! Oh, I almost just died of a heart attack. That was closer than it looked at the end. I nearly shit myself. Yeah, when you didn't get that side flip dive, I thought you were dead. Yeah, that was terrifying. But yeah, those melting sand blocks can be very jank. As you can see, Arya tried to get a ledge grab, but since the platform was moving downwards, she couldn't ledge grab it, and it just sent her into a free fall state, which is basically you can't do anything until you land. And the thing that you're landing on is a sand block that is disintegrating. So yeah, you have to act very fast in that situation. Thankfully, she managed to recover it and didn't die to that side flip dive at the end. But that was a very scary Serena 2 secret for Arya. Let's see if Rodeo can have a little bit less scariness in his. Also, Arya doing the banana split here. Very nice. Love to see it. Rodeo may opt to go for the momentum spin jump here. Doesn't seem like it, though. Seems like he's also just opting to keep it safe. Oh, Yeah. I was gonna say, I think... Oh my god. Rodeo did it. I don't know if that was intended or not. Rodeo did actually get the free fall state, but dived out of it. I forgot that you can actually still dive out of that. And yeah, used it to get to the end. That was either a very cool backup or just a very janky looking piece of movement that does just work consistently. I'll ask him. Let me write it down on my notepad. Forgive the typing. I will ask Rodeo that after the race, because I am interested if that was intended. So yeah, Arya now entering the casino. Unfortunately, not going to be playing any blackjack today, just looking to basically skip the entire thing. Because yeah, you can actually just jump straight over this wall, sidestep out of bounds, and enter the pipe. That was actually a really good pipe entry. And then we have Serena 4 secret. Which, yeah, has a quick strat at the start to get onto that cycle. Actually relatively difficult. Something I only learned, like, on the back half of my SMS playing. And yeah, these platforms are really nicely spaced that you can just do dive rollouts onto them. There is the chance to do a Beyblade off of this. I don't think Arya's gonna be going for it, and I completely understand why. Yeah, it just ups for a regular spin jump dive. The shine. Nice. That was still a very good Serena 4. Didn't see really any mistakes at all there. Saved 3 minutes on JJ from yesterday. Wait, did JJ die in that? What is it? Oh, wait. Oh, glitchless. It was a glitchless race, right? I would be so screwed if I did glitchless. I don't even know how to end a Serena 4 without doing casino skip. So yeah, Rodeo is going to be doing Serena 4, and Arya is now doing Serena 5, which is home to, I would say, the biggest amount of RNG this run has. Basically, during the King Boo fight, there are fruit cycles and there are basically garbage cycles. And in a normal RTA Serena 5, you want to get fruit on your first go, which is 70%, then trash, and then fruit again, which I'm not sure if that's 70%. I will assume it is. And then you get another guaranteed trash cycle, and then you get another fruit cycle, ideally. But there is a chance for every single like cycle that it's possible for you to get fruit on, there is a 30% chance that you don't get fruit. So like here with Arya, there is a 70% chance she gets fruit, which she did. But there was also a chance for an extra cycle there. There is no cap on the amount of extra cycles you can get. It's basically just running the 30% chance every single time. So there is a chance you can get really screwed. I think the most amount of extra cycles anybody has ever had is 12. And it obviously gets exponentially lower odds each time. So yeah, that wasn't bad RNG. There is a guaranteed trash cycle in between each fruit cycle, unless you do cycle skips, which is basically you spray King Boo as he comes up and then scare him off. And then when he comes up again, you spray him. And there is a chance, a 1 in 64 chance, that you actually get a fruit cycle out of that when you're meant to just be given trash. Because basically you just have to get lucky that the slot machine 100% randomly stops on the three fruits, which is a 1 in 64 chance, because it's just 1 in 4 cubed. So yeah, the chances of an ideal King Boo fight are about, I think, 1 in 5,000. with cycle skips. Whereas without cycle skips, it's just 70% cubed, which is 1 in 300. No. The opposite. It would be, yeah. Okay. I'm trying to think of the math. It's just 7/10 cubed. So it would be 343/1,000. So it's about like 34%, I would say. If my math isn't bad, I think I know 7 cube. So yeah, it's about a 34% chance of a perfect King Boo, which I think Arya actually did get there. Yeah. So yeah, Arya got the about 1 in 3 chance of a perfect King Boo by there. I don't know if Radio has had any cycles yet. I think Radio just started this fight. Does get fruit off the bat though, so that's nice. And yeah, you just want to hit King Boo with a pepper and then throw away. Oh, is this second phase? Did Radio get perfect first phase as well? It'd be crazy if we had like two perfect King Boo fights, because that would be 1 in 9 basically, which is about 11%. So yeah, it'd be pretty wild. Let's have a look. Does also get it? Damn. Some solid RNG for the runners in this SMS. If I wasn't mistaken that Radio did get fruit first try on phase one, I wasn't paying attention. But yeah, no extras at all. So yeah, about an 11% chance. I mean, JJ both got perfect. Okay, so that would be, what the hell is it? 9 cubed? Actually, wouldn't it just be squared? It would just be 1 in 81, which I don't know the odds of. 1 divided by 81 times 100. It's about a 1% chance of that happening. 1.23, very nice number. Maybe I'll add that to the stats sheet, because I am running the statistics for this tournament, if it wasn't obvious by the amount of fucking nerding out I just did about probabilities. So yeah, Arya just did Serena 6, which is actually easier for her than it is for Radio, because Radio is playing on the Japanese version, which, one, has a higher cleaning, like, goop cleaning requirement. You have to clear more goop off the beach for the challenge to finish. And also on the JP version, there is a chance of invisible goop, which is, I think, as far as I'm aware, a aspect of the 1.0 version of the game. Whereas the higher goop cleaning requirement is just because of the Japanese version, because games were usually made harder in Japan back in the day. If you remember, the version of SMB2 in Japan is generally considered to be the lost levels, whereas the version of SMB2 in the US is generally considered to be what is basically a reskinned version of a Japanese game called Doki Doki Panic. So yeah, because Lost Levels was considered too hard for Western audiences. So yeah, the Japanese version of SMS does follow suit in that regard, and is a little bit harder in Serena 6. Radio's still getting a decent Serena 6, despite that fact. Yeah, it's basically just a skill issue of Western casual players. Japan basically said, "You guys suck at video games." Yeah, it is interesting that we have these differences as a result of that. So yeah, Arya now entering, I think this is Noki 1. I don't think Arya's done Noki 1 yet. I'll be able to find out relatively. Okay, no, never mind, this looks like Noki 2. Unless I'm wrong. Wait, is there goop up here? Oh yeah, this is Noki 1, never mind. I forgot there wasn't any goop on this platform. Arya having a little bit of an issue with this wheel wall kick. Also, I just noticed that's a dolphin pattern on the wall there. I never have my camera this zoomed out, because I take a different route up Noki 1. This is Bianco 9. Me when I spread misinformation on the internet. Maybe that's why JP speedruns are just built different. Yeah, true. They just had harder video games when they were younger. So, Radio now finishing up Serena. We'll be heading into Noki 1 as well. And this is the last level of the run. We do Noki 1 through 7, and then we have Corona. So, this is Radio's last big chance to get ahead. Before Corona. I meant, like, last stage. You know what I meant, you asshole? Also, yeah, the reason Arya is cheering about no Noki 4. Noki 4 is known to be probably one of the most, not temperamental, but just annoying levels in this entire game. It is the eel fight, which we'll get into that when we get to Noki 4. In the meantime, we'll enjoy some half decent levels on the screen. Noki 4 is the best shine in the game. Nope. This is simply false information. So yeah, Radio heading up to Noki 1. At the top of Noki 1. Aria also going up to the same place. But we'll be doing very different movement. We're going to be seeing a out-of-bounds clip here in Noki 2 using a spring. Basically, if you spray the spring, it will go down to small size. And then you can pick it up. And when you place it down again, it will go back to normal size. So what we can do is Aria will spray the spring, pick it up, jump down, and shove herself into this corner, and then throw the spring, which will force Mario out of bounds. And then you can hover for a little bit in the air, then dive, and you will land directly in the little chamber where the shine is, which skips the third refight, or I guess the second refight, or the third fight of Goopa Bloopa in this game. It is crazy how bad of a fight Goopa Bloopa is, and it is crazy that Nintendo decided that we should fight him three times in this game. Thankfully, we get to avoid one of them, but we still have to do the one in Rico 4 and 5. At 4 and 5? 1 and 5. Glitches in this game forces Bloopa 2? Yep. Glitchless SMS is just a really unenjoyable experience, I'm starting to learn. I never considered the actual implications of SMS Glitchless until we had it last night. But yeah, there's some really shit aspects of Glitchless SMS. Like, this game is, I think, generally a pretty bad casual experience. But we don't even get the worst of it. We get to skip some of the really bad parts of this game. I'll say Radia now doing the Noki 2 clip, as Aria is in Noki 3, which is Red Coins. I think it's just called Red Coins in the Bottle. You have to collect Red Coins inside a giant bottle. It kind of does what it says on the tin. Yeah, Aria almost finished up with this. Pretty quick level, generally. Honestly, I really enjoy this level. The cum jar. Someone had to make it weird. Yeah, I actually really enjoy this level. When I don't get eaten by those giant fishes. But, yeah. Ben Bushnan. Aye, aye, Captain. Executing target. Target destroyed. Alright, I'll unban him. I'm not that mean. Based ban. When you get stuck, what? Oh, ah. What am I reading? Somehow we managed to get worse than fucking cum jar. Alright, it is time for Noki 4. Which, fun fact, starts off with 30 whole seconds of falling. I am not kidding you, there is no way to speed this up. We are set for, what is it? We are set waiting 30 seconds. Holy shit, I just found out something really interesting for the Valorant players in chat. They have created an anti-stream sniping mechanic where basically if Valorant detects you have one of the enemy team's streams open, it reveals your position to them permanently. That is crazy. Anyway, Aria starting off the eel. Sprays one tooth, sprays two tooth. Goes to spray the third one, doesn't finish it, but she probably will afterwards. And then I think from here... Oh, actually goes for a five tooth. Doesn't have time to do it though. So what she'll do here is she'll exit the eel's mouth while it's closing so that she doesn't get eaten. And then yeah, basically sprays off one of the corner teeth. So the eel has three corner teeth. If you spray one of them, it will provoke the eel into eating you. But if you can do it when the eel starts this like water sucking phase, the eel actually won't go down into the ground. And then yeah, we provoke it to close its mouth and sit basically inside the lips so that we can spray off the next tooth as soon as it opens again. And if Aria does this successfully, she should, yeah, that was a really good eel. That was solid as hell. Not a singular, cave return from the eel. didn't get the cutscene skip, but makes sense considering she was on pretty low health. Because basically, to do the cutscene skip, you get hit right before you spray out the last tooth. So usually you spray the tooth a little bit, hover into it to take damage, and then finish spraying it. We'll see if Rodeo goes for it here. Let's have a look what kind of heal Rodeo's going for. As first tooth, second, third, gets a fourth, and might actually be able to get a fifth tooth in here. Yeah, it does manage to get it. The eel now closes its mouth, opens it again, and then Radio's gonna spray one of the corner teeth. Provoke the eel into eating him, sprays the second corner tooth, and can hopefully provoke the eel again. Yep, gets a water sucking fit. I don't even know what causes that, honestly, but yeah, this is a really good eel. Radio, yeah, sitting inside the tooth to take damage, almost gets eaten. Doesn't get the cutscene skip, unfortunately. But yeah, still a decent eel from Radio. Honestly, just not getting eaten or having the eel return to its cave is good. So yeah, a decent eel from both. Unfortunately, no cutscene skips, but still not something that you can complain about much during a race. Well, we'll definitely take that. Unfortunately, the lack of cutscene skip on Radio's end does mean he won't get to save that time over Aria, which he is really starting to need. There are 4 shines left in the run. 3 Enoki and 1 being Corona, the last level. And one of them is basically an auto scroller, which is the one that Aria is doing now. You have to wait for Piantissimo here, kind of like in Pianta 2. Regardless of how long it takes you to finish, yeah, you still have to wait for Piantissimo. 7 is a scroller too. 7 is not a scroller. The fast kill is actually hard. Does it come down to 6 and fast boat? Yeah, that is, you are probably right though. Unless one of the runners messes up the quick kill in 7, which I mess up pretty often. I wouldn't blame the runners for messing it up. 5 is the only true auto-scroller, I'd say. Because everybody and their dog can beat this in 30 seconds. So, Rodeo now doing the Piantissimo race. Not really much interesting to see. We'll probably focus on Aria doing Noki 6, which is probably, I would say, the hardest secret in the game. Kind of unfortunate that it's also the last secret in the game. Actually, the sign tech exists. Alright, my bad. Who born in 1656? Joe Cool. 2015. Probably some XQC viewers born in that year. Mid-rope. I was trying to not make it personal. So yeah, Aria, unfortunately not getting the fast strat at the start. Gonna have to wait for this cycle here. Yeah, heading through the level as normal, wall kicking to that. And then a spin jump dive, ground pound onto that little rope. And then yeah, just some classic platforming up to here. Not going for green cycle, understandably. I think even if she'd have gotten the strat at the start, she would not be going for green cycle. Almost a bonk and almost a fall there. That was actually terrifying. It is insanely easy to die in Noki 6. It's actually impossible to die on this final... this final platform by clipping through it. Thankfully, no issues. Aria getting a really nice Noki 6 outside of a few scares. And yeah, now we're heading into the secret. Let's see how he fares. Might be able to save some time on Aria here if he can get the fast start. Does seem to be getting it. So yeah, there you go. That's what the fast start looks like. Also going for a spin jump dive there instead of a wall kick onto the platform, which will also save him a little bit. Oh, making the unfortunate mistake of diving before wall kicking, which yeah, does cause a bonk. Even if you are sliding off of the wall, you will bonk into it rather than diving away from it. That was a really scary rollout from Radio there. That was also a pretty scary rollout as well. Okay, both runners having absolutely terrifying Noki 6s. Thankfully, both not dying though. So, Yeah, Aria is now heading into Corona Mountain while Radio still has Noki 7 to do. This is very much Aria's race to lose here. I don't think there is much Radio can do if Aria doesn't make any mistakes. So it would be understandable for her to take this nice and not slow, but nice and consistent. I probably won't be going for fast boat or fast Corona or anything crazy like that. But it is still Corona Mountain. This is still probably one of the most, like, not bullshit, but yeah, probably one of the hardest levels in the game. Yeah, Radio getting the Noki 7 quick kill, no issue at all. And we'll now be heading into Corona Mountain himself, though unfortunately at about a 1 minute deficit, I would say. Radio does have a significant gap to try and overcome in the last few minutes of this run. But yeah, like I said, it's basically all on Aria at this point. As long as she gets to the end and finishes strong, she will take this match. Hopefully we will see no bullshit on this boat. Also, I haven't really been mentioning this much, but Aria's... Okay. Aria is on PB pace here. She could get a 122 and beat both of the runner's PBs as long as this ending goes well. Like, this has been a very strong showing in SMS ending from Aria. Like, even Radio's mistakes aside, as long as this ending goes well, Radio would have had to PB to beat Aria here. So, yeah. This may be a win and a PB for Aria. Which is crazy because Aria has already PB'd SMS Anyxen in this tournament. It's not like this is like an old or outdated PB. This is Aria's PB from recent time. So, yeah, this is it's a very impressive showing. We just have to hope for no annoying goop on this ending. Gets the first one. Doesn't get hit by goop. That's two. Does get gooped, but manages to stay on the platform. Doesn't even need a rocket to get back, actually. I did not see what Radio did. I feel bad that I didn't see what happened, but it seems like Chad got it, so that's what matters most. And as long as Aria doesn't get gooped here, this will be a 122. Oh, the ground pound. Should still make it, though. Nice. Good job, Aria. Really fucking strong race. So yeah, for those who weren't following, that is a 48-second PB for Aria. Also 29 seconds ahead of Radio's PB. And that's also Aria in Grand Finals. So we now have the bronze match and Grand Finals decided. The Grand Final will be Aria versus JJ. And the bronze match will be Udmi versus Radio, which is a pretty interesting turn of events based on seed. I'm honestly surprised Radio made it back to that platform. That is terrifying. Yeah, we do still get to see the clash of the titans, Udmi versus Radio, which I'm looking forward to. I'm also really down for an Aria JJ final. That seems pretty fun. Getting a very hype ending to this tournament, which I'm super glad about. And yeah, Radio with one last platform to ground pound here. Still getting a 123. Like, this is very good for a no reset. There you go. GG's to both runners. This is wicked. So yeah, I think Radio is not interested in doing an interview, which is semi understandable. But we do have Aria. Hello.
Hi.
How are you? It's a bit of a stupid question to ask, but how do you feel about that run? I imagine pretty good.
Decent. Decent, very decent is my answer, I think.
Yeah, decent run. We'll take that.
I think it was just clean. It was kind of just clean the whole way, and the movement was sloppy. I played consistent, but I picked up my time save at the start, and I just kind of carried it the whole way. Like, I was minus one away out of Piano 1, and I only dropped 20 seconds on that. To an otherwise cleanish PB to the end.
Yeah, this was a really, like, strong run overall. Like, you were even ahead out of Bianco, right? Like,
yeah.
This was pretty much like a... Yeah, this is like a consistently green run. So, yeah, we now have our grand finals decided. How are you feeling about going up against JJ?
It's just gonna come down to the wheel. That's all it is. It's he wins 64 sunshine. Oh, does he win? I don't know if he wins 60. I think the optimal order of games that we want, it goes, I destroy him in Odyssey, and then he destroys me in Sunshine, and then 64 determines it, is I think what we want.
Yeah, I mean, you both get a ban, right? Because you both have 5 games.
Oh, that's true. Wait, do we? In the finals.
Yeah.
If I get a ban, then I just destroy him, because he doesn't have anything else.
JJ doesn't have 3D World, and you don't have G2, so you both have 5 games.
Yeah, but I'm saying that we can probably alter the rules for the final, because if we both get a ban, then JJ only has 1 game on me. That's it.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, we could do that.
Because it's just a wash. I'd sit here for 7 hours and get a 329 G1 and win the game. I'd say 4 are coming for best of 3 is definitely a good idea.
Yeah, that is true.
If we both get a ban, we don't actually have 4-3 games.
Yeah, you know, I didn't even think about the fact that the final was best of 3. We do literally not have enough games if we ban in the final. So that probably...
JJ gets lucky again. He can't beat me with Sunshine in 64.
So, that will be your final. Aria versus JJ. And the wheel will be 64 SMS, G1, and SMO. A pretty even spread, given that both of you have 2 games that you have better PBs in. So it does seem like... I honestly really hope that 64 is the decider.
16. I wouldn't mind playing 16 as a decider.
Yeah.
I'm down for that. I do like 16 like, star.
Two of the games are pretty much guaranteed to be a wash. So it would be nice if the third game was 64. And then we can have a really, like... nice intense final.
Just Sunshine one of the first 2 games, that's all he needs, which he'll probably get given his luck given a tournament.
JJ has been blessed by this wheel during this tournament. It is insane. But so your final, one more time, your final will be Aria versus JJ, and your bronze match will be Odmi versus Radio. Neither of them are scheduled right now for obvious reasons. They just became even a thing. So I cannot give you any future updates on the tournament. There are currently no future matches scheduled. So keep your eye on the schedule on the spreadsheet. What is the command for the spreadsheet?
We have not scheduled either match because both matches require... Oh, the spreadsheet is just scheduled.
Ah, okay. Never mind then.
Yeah, but we gotta schedule them.
Yeah, makes sense.
Me and JJ, that's so funny actually. Me and JJ were talking like a couple days ago, like 24 hours ago. We were like, send him!
Wait, let me put this in.
Wait.
Yeah, Aria won mid, bro.
Wait, yeah. So we actually time already.
Bronze match. Pepe love. But
that'll be the gold match though.
Yeah, that will be grand finals. Yeah, so that will probably be it. Yeah, Friday. What, 8 PM Eastern? You said it was.
Yep. Oh, 8 PM.
8 p.m. Eastern, that is fucking 1 a.m. for me, man.
I'm sorry. We gotta start early, though.
Fucking armies.
It's 3 a.m. for me, man. I'm complaining.
But yeah, I think that will be us for now. We won't wrap this up. GG's to Aria, commiserations to Radio. Thanks everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed the match. I definitely did. We will see you next time for either the bronze match or the grand finals, depending on which one comes first. That's it. I have been your commentator, Sauce28. We will see you next time. Also, shout out to Frozina for restreaming last second. Yeah, that's about it. We'll see you guys next time. Goodbye. See you all later. Ciao, ciao.
Bye.